Good afternoon, Namaskar. I, Kriti Vadera, would like to welcome all the teachers, learners, students to CIT NCERT's live phone-in program. And you are watching us live on PME Vidya's channel number 10. This session is going to be for standard 10 students. Science is the subject which we will be taking up in the next 30 minutes. And we will be discussing about carbon and its compounds. And the expert who has joined us today for this discussion, I would like to introduce Dr. Shefali Shukla, Assistant Professor from Sri Venkateshwara College, University of Delhi. We welcome you to PME with
you,
Shefali.
Thank you, Kriti.
And before we start with this live interaction program, I would like to remind you here that if you have any queries, any questions, then do let us know. You can dial on our toll-free numbers. Number would be 8800440559. And if you want to watch the live streaming of this program, kindly log into our official YouTube channel, NCERT Official. And there also in the live chat box, you can send all your suggestions and questions. Certainly, we will be taking up all of them in the last segment of this program. There is one more medium through which you can contact us. You can send all your suggestions and questions to dth.class10@ciet.nic.in. So let's begin today's session on carbon and its compounds. I welcome you again, Dr. Shefali Shukla. What are we going to discuss in this chapter?
So, yeah, Kriti. So today's topic would be the discussion about the carbon and its compounds.
Yeah.
So when we talk about the carbon and its compounds, let us first understand why is it important to understand what is carbon, why the compounds of carbon are so important, and then gradually we'll move into the topic where we'll be talking about the various types of bonding which the carbon forms, and then we'll take it further to the hydrocarbons in today's session.
Right.
Okay. So, students, today, first of all, we'll be talking about, as I have told you, the carbon and its compounds. The electronic configuration of carbon, as it is written here, the atomic number of carbon is 6. So when I say the atomic number of carbon is 6, means it can form, the electronic configuration of carbon is 2 in the innermost shell and then 4 electrons in the outer shell. Okay. So before we actually go into the details of what is what impact it has on the bonding, having 4 electrons in the outermost shell, let us first understand why the study of the carbon and its compound is important to us in our daily life. You just look around. When we see around, what do we see in day-to-day life? We eat food. So everything which we eat, whether it is carbohydrates, whether it is proteins, whether it is minerals, everything, it has carbon. They are all compounds of carbon. So whatever we are eating in our day-to-day life, they are all carbon compounds. The coal and petroleum, without which our life cannot move, they are also compounds of carbon. The fabric, the clothes which we wear, they are also compounds of carbon. They are the polymers of carbon. Means the carbon, they cannot be formed unless and until you have a carbon in them. Then the perfume industry, the cosmetics which we are using in day-to-day life, they are all compounds of carbon. The medicines which we eat, the explosives, the various compounds which we are using, the war gases, nowadays we talk a lot about the chemical warfare. So all these compounds, they are of carbon. The carbon forms the backbone. So carbon is attached to different entities to form these various chemical compounds, various chemical species. Okay.
Yeah. Shefali ji, we are hardly aware of these facts. As a layman, if I talk about, we don't know. I mean, if we are not going into the detail that we are so much surrounded with carbon.
It is only
in
carbon.
Day-to-day life.
Yes, it is only the compounds of carbon we are dealing with.
Yeah.
As I told you, whether it is the fabrics or the medicine or the
cosmetic industry.
So everything is the compound of carbon. So that is why the compounds of carbon, it holds a very special position in the branch of chemistry, and they are always dealt separately. Okay. So as it explains why the carbon chemistry is so important, because carbon compounds, they are more than 5 million compounds. Whereas if you take other elements of the periodic table, hardly together they are able to form 70,000 compounds. So carbon compounds, they hold a very special importance in our life. As I told you, the carbon, it has 2 electrons in the innermost shell, because we know that the electronic configuration of carbon is 2 in the inner shell and 4 electrons in the outer shell. Okay, in the nucleus it has 6 neutrons and 6 protons. 6 protons, they are positively charged entities which are surrounded by 6 electrons. So when we talk about the stable configuration of the compounds, stable configuration means having a noble gas configuration. And when we have a noble gas configuration, the octet should be complete. So either there should be 2 electrons or 8 electrons. So when we are talking about the electronic configuration in the carbon. So now if I want to attain the stable configuration for the carbon, either I have to lose the 2 compounds, 4 electrons, or I need to gain 4 electrons. So if I gain 4 electrons, then in the outermost shell I will have 8 electrons, and if I lose 4 electrons, then I will have 2 electrons in the outermost shell. Now what happens is, because we have 6 protons which are counterbalancing the negative charge of the electrons, so these 4 electrons, if I lose, then the carbon will become highly positive. So if I knock out 1 electron, the 6 protons, they are holding these 5 electrons. So the net effective positive charge on each carbon, on each electron, will be more. If I again remove second electron, so I have to use more energy, because now they are strongly held by the nucleus. Again, if I take out the third electron and fourth electron, so it is not possible, practically not possible, to lose these 4 electrons. So what other option do I have now? Then to attain the noble gas configuration, I should take 4 more electrons to make 8 electrons in the outermost shell. But as we all understand that the electrons in the outermost shell, they are held by the protons of the nucleus. Now if I put 4 more electrons, I do not have protons which can hold these 4 extra electrons. Okay, so these 6 protons will not be able to hold the 10 electrons, 2 from here and 8 in the outermost shell. So these 6 protons will not be able to hold the 4 more electrons in the outermost shell here. Okay, so that explains why the carbon is not able to either lose 4 electrons, or it is able to gain 4 more electrons, because to knock out 4 electrons, you need very, very high amount of energy, which is not possible. And to give 4 electrons to the carbon, again that is not possible, because protons will not be able to hold these 4 more electrons in the outermost shell. Okay, is it clear? So now let us move to, then what happens when the carbon has to form bonds? Before we actually go into the detail what type of bonding carbon undergoes, let us understand what are the different types of bondings which are possible. One type of bonding is give and take types, where those elements which are able to give their 1, 2 or 3 electrons, which are very easy for them, it is easy to give out 1 or 2 electrons or maximum 3 electrons. Such type of bonding is known as give, where one element is giving the electrons and the other element which is taking those electrons. For example, in case of sodium chloride, sodium is giving 1 electron and chlorine is taking one electron. Okay, so here when I say in case of sodium, this sodium, it loses one electron to form sodium plus to attain the noble gas configuration. Similarly, chlorine, it belongs to the halogen family. It needs one electron because it has 7 electrons in the outermost shell. So it needs one electron to attain the noble gas configuration. So what happens is, the sodium, it loses one electron, which is taken by the, this electron is taken by the chlorine to form the chloride ion. So now sodium also has the noble gas configuration, chlorine also has the noble gas configuration, and eventually they will end up forming a ionic compound, that is sodium chloride. Now when we talk about the carbon, as I have told you, in the outermost shell carbon has 4 electrons. So because carbon is not able to either lose these 4 electrons or gain 4 electrons, so what carbon does is, carbon, it involves itself into the covalent. Covalent means sharing. So I would say carbon is a very friendly atom. So it neither wants to lose nor it wants to gain, but it wants to share its electron with the other carbon species so that both they have a noble gas configuration. Okay. So now when I talk about the covalent bonding, let us take again a very simple example of the hydrogen, which has one electron in the outermost shell. So hydrogen, it needs only one more electron to get the noble gas configuration. So when it is involved in the covalent bond formation, one hydrogen contributes one electron, the other hydrogen also contributes one electron to form a covalent bond. Okay, but the bond which is formed by sharing. Okay, because hydrogen, it doesn't want to lose its electron to form the H plus. Similarly, the other hydrogen doesn't want to take one electron to form H minus, as they have only one proton. Okay, so here, this, then the better situation here is to form the bond by sharing the electron. So as the picture shows you, this hydrogen, it has one electron in the outermost shell, then by the covalent bonding, it is able to form the hydrogen gas. Okay, it is not that hydrogen cannot lose the electron ever. It loses the electrons in the, when we talk about the acids. So when hydrogen is attached to a very, very electronegative atom or something which is very strongly demanding, so then hydrogen is not able to hold its electron, because then the hydrogen is attached to a very negative atom, like in HCl molecule, the chlorine molecule then pulls the electron towards itself, which gives a partial positive charge to the hydrogen, because the electron cloud is more towards the chlorine. Okay, now let us take another example. When we talk about the fluorine, as I have told you, fluorine, chlorine, they all belong to the halogen family. So they need only one electron to form the noble gas configuration. So fluorine, when it is attached to another fluorine molecule, these fluorine atoms, because they are not attached to any more electronegative atom, it is attached to the atom of its own kind. Okay, so it will not lose electron, the other fluorine will not gain electron. So eventually what happens? The sharing of bond. Okay, the sharing, the bond is formed by sharing, and that is how we say the fluorine gas is produced by the sharing of electron, which leads to, okay, one thing more I would like to tell you here is, when we talk about the bonding, So one atom or one element is contributing one electron, the other element is contributing another electron, and then there is a bonding between them. One electron and one electron, they always result in a single bond. So one bond comprises of two electrons, okay? So these two electrons together, they form one bond, okay? Sharing of bond. So this is how we show the sharing of bond, means hydrogen is contributing, the other hydrogen is contributing, and this pair, which is technically between these two hydrogen, is shared by this. As you can see, the outer circle of this hydrogen has both the electrons. Similarly, the outer circle of this hydrogen has both the electrons. So this electron pair is shared by both the atoms. This is known as the covalent bonding, and all the carbon atoms, they undergo the covalent bonding to form the numerous compounds with different elements. So let us extend it a little when we talk about the most simple organic compound, that is the molecule of methane. So when we talk about methane, so the carbon has four electrons, each hydrogen has one electron. Carbon needs four more electrons to complete its octet. Hydrogen needs one electron to complete its octet. So what happens? This carbon is able to form one bond with the carbon here, another bond with the carbon-hydrogen bond, the third carbon-hydrogen bond, and the fourth carbon-hydrogen bond. Okay? So this leads to the formation of a methane molecule, where all these eight electrons, four electrons are contributed by carbon, and these four electrons, these dot which I have represented, these four electrons, they are contributed by each of the hydrogens to give you a methane molecule, which is an example of a covalently linked molecule. So as I have told you, this is about the formation of single bonds. So this carbon has four single bond, one single bond, second single bond, third single bond, and fourth single bond. So a methane has four single bonds. Next, let us study about the double bond formation. Like you see in many molecules, we represent, like in oxygen, we always write, we do not write one single bond. We write two lines like this, or a double bond. So when we talk about a double bond, what is the meaning of a double bond? Let us look at the configuration of oxygen. In the configuration of oxygen, the oxygen molecule has two electrons in the inner shell, and it has six electrons in the outer shell. So when it has six electrons, means to attain the noble gas configuration of 2-8, how many electrons it needs? It needs two electrons. Similarly, the other oxygen, it has two electrons in the inner shell, and it has six electrons in the outer shell. So if they are able to form a bond where the two electrons, they are shared by both the oxygen atoms, okay, you can see this oxygen is sharing these two electrons from this, and similarly this oxygen is able to share these two electrons from the other oxygen. So when I say this type of bonding, it occurs, it leads to the formation of a double bond, means one bond by sharing of one electron pair, the other bond by sharing of the other electron pair. So these type of bonds, they are known as the double bonds. Now Now the question is, do we have a double bond in the organic compounds also? Yes, we do have. Like in the previous example, we have studied about the methane molecule. The next example which I have taken here is the ethane molecule. Now in the ethane molecule, when I say this carbon has 4 electrons in the outermost shell, the other carbon also has 4 electrons in the outermost shell. One possibility we have studied is this carbon is forming a single bond with hydrogen. It is not mandatory that the carbon has to form a bond with the hydrogen only. It can form single bonds with many other compounds, like in case of ethane molecule. The carbon has formed bonds with 6 hydrogens here, 3 single bond here and 3 single bonds here, and there is one carbon-carbon bond which is formed by the sharing of electron pair between the two carbons. Similarly, in case of ethene molecule, it is possible that these two carbons, they share 2 electrons and form a double bond, and these 4 electrons which we are left with, they can form bond with the hydrogens like this. So this is how we say that in case of ethene molecules, the carbon-carbon bonding is not a single bond type, but it is a double bond type. Okay, like here these two electron pair, they are shared together. So as it is shown in the slide also, here these two carbons, they are forming the electron pair, 2 electrons from here, 2 electrons from here, and they are able to form 4 electrons to form one bond, second bond, and these carbon hydrogen bonds, they form the, together they form the ethene molecule. Okay, like here, this is how the molecule can be represented in a structural formula. Now let us talk about the triple bond. Triple bond means having 3 bonds between 2 atoms, one bond, second bond and the third bond. When we talk about having a 3 bond, now I think it has become very simple to all of you. When we talk about the formation of 3 bonds, means 3 electrons are being shared, each atom is contributing 3 electrons for sharing, the other atom is also contributing 3 electrons for sharing, and together they are able to form 6 electrons in between, means 3 bonds, which are shown by one single line, second single line and the third single line, means 3 bonds. Okay, this is known as the triple bond formation in the molecule. Like I have shown you, in case of nitrogen gas, it has 3 bonds. The electronic configuration of nitrogen is, nitrogen needs 3 electrons. Okay, so its electronic configuration is 2 and 5, so it needs 3 electron. The other nitrogen atom also needs 3 electron. In the nitrogen molecule, these 3 electrons are shared to form the triple bond. Applying the same concept in the organic chemistry, means in the compounds of carbon. So here in these compounds of carbon, we simply we can extend what we have learned in the triple bond formation, that there are 6 electrons, 3 from each carbon are coming to give you a triple bond between the 2 carbons, and the 4th electron forms a single bond with the hydrogen of both the carbons. Okay, this is how structural formula of the ethyne molecule is written. Means there are triple bond between the 2 carbons and single bond with the hydrogen. The electron dot structure we all are familiar with. Here in the electron dot structure, the electrons of carbon, they are shown by the cross, and the electrons of hydrogen, they are shown by the dot here. And that is how in the ethyne there are 1, 2, and 3 single bond in between, and 1 single bond here with the hydrogen and the other single bond with the other hydrogen.
Right. And Dr. Shwali, with this we are almost into the last minutes of the program. I would like you to please conclude the presentation.
Yeah. So when we say, so this is what I wanted to show you.
Yeah.
To conclude, when we talk about the single bond, means one electron pair is participating. When we talk about a double bond, 2 electron pairs are participating. And when we talk about a triple bond, the 3 electron pairs, they are participating to form a single, double and triple bond respectively. So the number of bonds formed, it depends on the number of electrons participating.
So in terms of examination, if I ask you, this formation of the bonds is very important in this chapter?
This forms the basis of what we are learning ahead.
Okay.
So we are not other, if you don't understand the bonding, how it occurs, how to write the formula, we will not be able to understand the chemistry of the carbon. So this forms the foundation of, it is very important to understand the chemistry of carbon, and which can be possible only if you understand how the bonding is done in the various carbon compounds, where it is a single bond, where it is a double bond, and where it is a triple bond.
Right. So indeed, viewers, you have to grab whatever has been delivered to you in this particular session, as it is the foundation of chemistry, what Dr. Shwali Shukla has taught today. And Dr. Shwali Shukla, you have explained it so well to our viewers. We really thank you for joining us today.
Thank you, Kriti.
I'm sure you will be noting whatever Dr. Shukla has explained you today, as it's going to help you in many ways, as it is the foundation of chemistry. And to watch NCERT's resource material, remain connected to PM eVidya. Thank you.